Things can get a little tricky on PC, for me, anyway. I have the chat on iPad, so it's going to be a little bit harder to pay attention to you guys, but I will do the best that I can. So this is Tyranny. This is new from Obsidian. I'm super excited about it. I was a big fan of Pillars of Eternity. And it is a cool Infinity Engine sort of style RPG where you're evil. You're the bad guys. That's really all I know about it, outside of watching Day 9, who's a wonderful, wonderful gentleman. Play it for a little bit. So I'm going in fresh. I wanted to go in fresh for you guys. I thought it'd be more fun that way. And yeah, we're going to play through. We're going to check in with Godfrey and Sadro real quick. And they're pumped. They were big fans of Pillars of Eternity as well. They actually think that that game didn't get enough love from people. And I agree with them. So yeah, the cacti are doing well. Alright, so it seems like everybody is, no one's complaining, so I'm going to take that as a good sign that we can go ahead and hit that new game button. We're going to get to create a character, I believe. But I don't know, don't know. Alright, so we've got difficulty, we've got story mode, minimum micromanagement, and easily forgives mistakes in combat. Normal requires strategy and efficiency, but forgives a few mistakes in combat. Companion combat AI is enabled by default, okay. Hard. And then Path of the Damned. Enemies receive a boost to most stats. Well, it might be fun to do a harder difficulty setting. Because I am going in fresh, we're just going to do normal. Expert mode disables a lot of helper features, and Trial of Iron, you only get one save slot. If your party's defeated, the game ends. Yeah, we're definitely not going to do that. I actually want to show you guys the game. So we're just going to do normal. I know that's boring, but forgive me. We got a resub. Help me out with these, chat. I'm probably going to miss a lot of these. I actually am logged into my personal account, so who resubbed? Please let me know who resubbed. Whoever you are, thank you so much. The support really helps us, and I'm going to give you love and respect. But yeah, I'm going to need your guys' help on notifications, or if you like are giving me advice and I'm not seeing it, you might have to repeat yourself more than normal. Easy Allies, Path of the Casual confirmed. That's right. Stephen Colbert 36, that's who it was. For 6 months in a row. Thank you, Stephen Colbert 36. Story time.
For over 400 years, the armies of Kairos the Overlord have swept across the known world. All who stood against them fell before their might. Even the Archons, women and men of immense power, were forced to kneel, chained to the Overlord's will. Now Kairos's final conquest has come to our corner of the world, and two of the Overlord's armies compete for the honor of taking our lands. The elite disfavored, and the teeming horde of the Scarlet Chorus. The voices of Narat, spymaster and archon of secrets, guides the fierce and undisciplined masses of the Scarlet Chorus. With each battle, the Scarlet Chorus grows stronger as the defeated are given a simple choice. Serve or die.
Like that.
Graven Ash, Archon of War and the Overlord's most loyal general, leads the disfavored. Though small in number, Kairos's ironclad legion has never met true defeat in open battle. Watching over the two generals is Tunon, the Adjudicator, Archon of Justice, eldest of Kairos's minions. Tunon brings Kairos's laws to newly conquered lands, aided by the Fatebinders, judges and executioners of the Overlord's laws. You were among the youngest of the court of Fatebinders when Kairos's armies came to our lands. How could we have known that the fate of thousands would rest in your hands?
Cool. Setting the tone. I like it. Somebody said bump up the game audio a bit, please. I will definitely do that as soon as I am able to. Once we get in the game here. So thank you for letting me know. All right. We get to make our character. This is always so fun. All right. In the Northern Empire, where you were born, women enjoy equal protections under the laws of the overlords, Kairos. In the Southern Lands of the Tears, women may crew a ship, but only men may own or captain a vessel. While these customs gave the oceans to men, the lands are trusted to the women. Men may rent and lease, but only women may own land and bequeath it to their daughters and sisters. While following a parent's profession is standard, many women choose to pledge service to one of the overlord's powerful archons. Those without a viable trade or lands to call their own are often drafted into the armies of the archons, where it is assumed they will rise to glory or vanish in obscurity according to their worth. Okay. You know, for Monster Hunter, we made a dude. Let's make a lady this time. Let's mix it up. What do we want to be? What do we want to be? Okay, we'll go with this. I really like the character models in this game. This looks good. What face do we want? This is a very serious face. I kind of like the serious face. We'll stick with that. And what do we want for hair? Hair is very important to us. Ooh, I kind of like this. I like this a lot. We'll pick that. I like the red too. We'll go with the red hair. I feel like our lady is tougher than a noble. So let's see what aggressive sounds like.
My wounds are slowing me down. Interesting.
All right. I like that. Let's try sneaky.
Flawless. You learn something every day. I'll just hold on to this. Ah, got it.
I kind of like sneaky, to be honest. I'm actually going to stick with sneaky. Oh, we can get tattoos. This is fun. All right, what do we want for tattoos? I like those. There are a lot of options. I like this as well. Runes in the arms. Sun. Hand tattoos. I actually kind of like these face tattoos. I don't know if I'm going to stick with it. I think we should have a tattoo of some sort. Ooh, snake on the leg. That's kind of cool. Alright. What was the one that I initially liked? We'll get some runes on our arms. How about that? We'll go with that. Don't want to spend too much time here. We only have 2 hours. I want to show you guys as much of the game as possible. So what is a perfect portrait for our lady? Are we going to be a warrior? Are we going to be a spellcaster? What are we going to be? I kind of like this portrait a lot. I like the idea. Maybe it's just because I've been playing Monster Hunter and swinging a giant sword around, but I kind of like the idea of being a warrior. We'll do this. I like this portrait. We're going to go ahead and hit next. All right. How did you join Kairos' army? I like this. This is like a background in 5th edition. These things. All right. Pit Fighter. That sounds appealing. So which ones do we like just by their name? I like Pit Fighter, Soldier, Lawbreaker. I think those are the three. So we're going to read those three real quick. Not wishing to pay to feed a house and house too, the madam that purchased your mother sold you to the Proving Grounds. Wow. The Northern Empire's bloodiest, most notorious fighting arena. Given only enough training to assure the show isn't over too soon, your natural prowess and survival instinct led you to one victory after another. There was no elegant swordplay, no formalized duels, just brutal melee and the stench of blood, shit, and bronze with each day's gruesome necessities. That sounds really appealing to me. Let's read a little bit of Soldier here. Unable to settle the year's accounts with grain, your parents offered you as a tithe. Tithe, is that tithe or tithe? To the overlord Overlord instead. Seeing your first battle as a child, you've known all your life how to fight, how to stay calm at the sight of blood and disembowelment, how to rely on your fellow warriors. Deemed smarter than the average killer, you were groomed for command and given an education in letters and numbers. Okay, so I think I like Pit Fighter more than Soldier. Accused of a crime you most certainly did commit, you stood before Tunon, the Adjudicator, Archon of Justice, and argued your case with eloquence and conviction. Impressed by your logic, reason, and confidence, he found you guilty anyway. It is rumored that Tunon selects many of his agents from his prisoners. Who better to catch the wicked than those versed in such ways? Okay. I think Lawbreaker's interesting too, but Pit Fighter's the one for me. The ruggedness of the Pit Fighter I like. We can RP Lars. Kind of, yeah. Kind of. Alright, so primary expertise. I'm good. I think we're making a really tough lady here, and so I think Greatsword makes sense. We gotta do it. I would pick axes. That's not an option, but we'll do that. Oh yeah. Look at our tattooed lady Pitfire with this giant sword. All right, this is off to a good start, I think. We got a resub. Who resubbed? Help me out. Oh man, I need to log out of this account and get into Easy Allies. Yeah, let me know who resubbed and I will totally give you some good old Sophies. All right. Choose an ability, Sunder. 70 to 23 slash, pierce base, okay, versus parry. Sunder for 20 seconds. Delivers a powerful overhead attack that reduces the target's armor, okay. Cleave, a sweeping cone attack that hits multiple enemies at once. I really like Cleave. I like those multi-kills, we're doing that. Yeah, we're doing Cleave, and we're hitting next. Secondary expertise. Spear and shield, javelin, dual-wielding, armor attacks, short bow, shock spells, vigor spells, atrophy spells. Dual-wielding sounds pretty cool. I also like the idea of punching fools, and I think as a pit fighter, you know, sometimes we'd have to rely on our fists, right? Sometimes we don't have the luxury of a weapon, so I think we're going to do unarmored attacks. Alright, so what's going to be our abilities? Nico Delfiki resubscribed. Thank you so much, Nico Delfiki, for the subscription. I love you so much. Thank you for the support. It means a lot. Love and respect. And I'm gonna give you a sneaky little PJ. You got a sneaky little PJ there. Alright, unleash a double attack on your targets for your blows. Classic palm strike. Perform a powerful palm strike to the target's chest, interrupting them, pushing them back, and silencing them from spellcasting. Well, we can't not pick that, I think, right? That makes too much sense. Cool. Ooh, we get to pick a banner as well. All right, we have a lot of options. We got to pick our emblem before we pick anything else. I actually like the default black and gold it's giving us a lot. What is something for our pit fighter? I think this is pretty pit fighter-y. The sword works as well. The fist, I like. Or we're just like counting our kills. That's pretty cool. That's really cool, actually. This axe is really cool. I don't know. I like counting the kills, but there's something about the fist that's so simple and clean. I like it. What if we did red and then black? Yeah. All right. That's cool. I'm into that. And then maybe we should match our banner with our character colors. How does the red and black look here? What if we do black and red? Yeah. All right. That works for me. That works for me. Enter name. All right, so whenever I make I have a default name for a dude and a lady whenever I play role-playing games. And my lady name is always Mirella, 100% of the time. I don't know why that is. It's just the name I came up with. But it is what it is. All right, now we get to pick our attributes. And we're going heavily into might. All right, so what is it telling us here? This attribute is recommended for you because you're training in Greatsword. Of course it is. All right, so finesse... attributes your character's physical and mental precision. All right, so this is recommended to us because of unarmed attacks. I think we're going to prioritize might over finesse. Quickness. This is for unarmed attacks. Determines a character's ability to endure physical and mental challenges. Okay. We also want high vitality, I think. So we have 8 points. We're going to put 4 into might. We're going to put 2 into vitality, and we're going to put 2 into resolve. I'm not sure if this is smart or not. I haven't played this game. But that makes some amount of sense to me. This is a primary, because resolve is the primary attribute used to derive the endurance, will, and magic defenses. Yeah, I like that. I like that. Wits is used to increase spell strength. We don't care about that at all. How often a character can use their abilities and spells in combat. Accuracy of attacks. Accuracy of attacks might be more important than magic defenses, I guess. Maybe we'll do that. So maybe we'll do 2 in vitality and 2 in finesse. I do want to be accurate with my big sword swings. All right. Again, I don't follow my example. I don't know what I'm doing, but I'm just making a guess here. Reduce other stats so we have more might? Absolutely. We don't need any wits, so let's reduce that. I actually am going to lower quickness as well. That's a good idea, you guys. That's a really good idea. I'm going to bump up vitality and finesse even more. I actually think I'm going to keep resolve where it is to prioritize these things even more. That was a great idea. I don't know why I just didn't do that immediately. I always do that in Infinity Engine style games, but I didn't this time. Okay, skills. We have 20 available skills. We're going heavy. We're going to put half of our points into... Wait, where did we start at? Did we start at 32? We're going to 42 here. Yeah, okay, points available 10. That's what we want. We're going to put half in unarmed combat. Because this is all we care about with fighting. We only want to use big two-handed weapons or our fist, I think. All right, what else do we want? Athletics. The skill is strongly recommended to you because you're training in greatsword and unarmed combat. Determines a character's ability to traverse difficult to win, as well as their ability to execute complicated maneuvers in combat. Athletics is also used in dialogue to determine your ability to intimidate. We want to intimidate very, very badly. More than anything else, we want to intimidate people. We're putting 5 points into that. No regrets. Should have 40 athletics. Yeah, we are doing 40 athletics for sure. I'm glad somebody in chat agrees with me. We want to intimidate the heck out of people. All right, how do you want to continue? Selecting Conquest option will allow you to play through Kyrus' Conquest of the Tears, choosing how your character was involved in the invasion. This gives you the most control over the starting state of the game and how other factions react to your character. That sounds really cool. What is Quick Start? Selecting Quick Start option will bypass the Conquest phase of your character. I think we want to do Conquest, you guys. We want to see how our character was involved in this... And this invasion, how can we skip that? All right, we're doing that. Here we go, game begins. Morella is made.
All the world has fallen to Kairos. And now the Overlord's eye is on the Tears, our home. The last corner of the world free of Kairos's reign. Two armies, the Disfavored and the Scarlet Chorus, march south from the Northern Empire. The last realm to fall to Kairos a century prior.
I really like the ominous music in this game, and the art so far has been fantastic.
In the early days of 428, Kairos' armies arrive at the Gates of Judgment, the mountainous border that we Tearsmen so long believed unassailable. Unable to agree on a unified plan of defense, the various leaders of the Tears sit and wait for each other to deal with the conquerors. Until it's too late.
Sounds like bad news. Alright, during the conquest, you will decide your character's action during Kyrus' invasion of the Tears, shaping the world through which you will adventure over the course of the game. This is really cool. Just immediately investing you in this world. That's fantastic. Each choice you make affects your character and how major factions of the Tears respond to you. Your decisions matter. Choose wisely. 428, year one of Kyrus' conquest. The Bastard City. Oh, I like this. This is a good way to give you more information about names you might be unfamiliar with. All right. The Bastard City stood on the northern border between Kyros' empire and the Tears, built upon a natural harbor at the crossroads between realms. The city was a nexus of commerce. To the Tears, it was the center of all wealth. To a northerner, it was little more than a backwater trading post. Its symbolic status as a gateway to the continent made it a natural first target in Kyros' military conquests. Circumstances were ideal for you to prove your worth as a soldier in Kyros' armies. Taking this city would send a message to the rest of Tears. Kyros' will is insurmountable. Select a token on the map to begin. Gates of Judgment. In the first major engagement of the war, Kyros' armies crossed the mountains and established a foothold. Infiltrate the Tears. Both armies sent forces to prepare the way. Let's do Gates of Judgment. The armies of Kyros took the battle to the Gates of Judgment, trumpeting the opening call of conquest of the Tears. The two armies brought their distinctive sense of order and chaos to the assault. You went to battle alongside the army who approached best suited your strength. Join the battle alongside those favored. I liked the Scarlet Chorus a little bit more in the opening, so we're going to pick them. You rush with the chaotic mass of the Scarlet Chorus, flanked the Bastard City's army, and drove them to flee. All right, so let's read about these two different factions to make sure we're making the choice that's best for us. The Scarlet Chorus is little more than a gang of thugs and their captive slaves. Rather than organized under commissioned officers, the Chorus follow a hierarchy seemingly ruled by whoever has the bravado to command and defend their position. At the head of this chaotic pecking order, the Archon of Secrets, better known as the Voices of Nerat, treats the Scarlet... Okay, so we got enough there. Kyros is the name out of legend. For centuries, the Overlord has consolidated power, sending vast armies to swell entire realms. The most powerful mystic the world has ever seen. Kyros can issue edicts, magical... They deal with magic and mysticism. Our Pitfire doesn't want anything of that. We just want to swing a giant sword. So I think we're going to go with the Scarlet Chorus. Sounds like the right choice for our Pitfighter. Winfishy says, I agree with you, Winfishy. Let's go with the Scarlet Chorus. You caught the mercenary army unprepared for the mania and disorder of the Scarlet Chorus. Your forces overwhelmed the Tears' defenses in a few short hours, hacking and burning their way into the continent. Any mercenaries who survived the battle found themselves initiated into the Scarlet Chorus, tortured by ruthless interrogators, or made the sport of competition as the army marched ruthlessly forward. Okay, now remember, guys, we're in this game, we're very, very evil. So we might do some pretty bad things. Okay, so that was one choice. Feeding the host, you found a way to feed Kyros' armies into enemy territory. Judge the enemy. You decided the fate of enemy soldiers captured in battle. I like that. We're picking that. The soldiers of the Tears fell by the hundreds, and Kyros' armies could not agree on how to handle what few survivors they dragged back to camp. Befitting your role, the commanders turned to you. Why are they turning to a pit fighter? To decide the fate of those who occupied prison pens. There were only enough prisoners to support the plan of a single army. I think we're just going to go all in on the Scarlet Chorus, but we'll see. You gave prisoners the chance to serve in Kyros' army or die. The Scarlet Chorus was in need of extra troops to fill up the vanguard, and your former enemies will occupy these slots nicely. Okay. The disfavored needed slaves to haul their gear, dig latrines, and keep their pallets warm at night. You consigned the survivors of battle to their subservient role among Graven Ashes noble troops. So they're serving nobles? We're putting them to war. I think our Pitfighter would like that more. We're gonna do Scarlet Chorus once again. You armed cooperative ex-soldiers with scrap weapons and tossed them out into the vanguard of the next Scarlet Chorus assault. Those who survive were welcome to take up the arms and armor of the fallen and eke out a desperate struggle. Yeah, they're warriors to survive in Kyros' military. After their first victory, you rewarded the new recruits with the opportunity to execute their wounded or reluctant countrymen. Brutal. The army of Kyros amassed around the Bastard City, the first bastion of the Tears to fall. Both armies longed to storm the walled outpost, the Scarlet Chorus howling for plunder, and the disfavored forming an unbreakable shield wall. Your prowess on the field of battle had carried them this far, but there was one more step before victory. Both of the armies had inspired schemes to take the Bastard City, but which did you support? Scarlet Chorus. Ooh, what abilities do we get? We got Searing Palm. Gather heated energy into your hand and release it onto a foe. The target ignites into flames, burning over time. That works with our unarmed ability. What do we get for being disabled? You create a cloud of obscuring shadows and dust. No. Too magical. We don't want that. No. No shadows. We don't deal with that. Warrior's Respite. Stand your ground in the face of defeat. During this time, you regenerate health rapidly, but your damage is significantly reduced. I actually think that fits our character really well, but we're not joining these disfavored scumbags. We're going Scarlet Chorus. It was passing strange to barricade the very gates you sought to cross, but it all made sense when the fires began. The Scarlet Chorus sent a constant rain of flaming arrows over the walls of the Bastard City, a plague that lasted through long days and tireless nights. By the end, the blaze was too much for the city defenders to contain. Citizens crowded at the gates, pleading to be freed from the smoldering city. You and your army were happy to oblige them. When the gates opened, they opened from inside. I like these decisions. The Bastard City settled into a new state of normalcy, with every tower displaying Kyros' banner. Your name was whispered alongside rumors of a decorated career to come. The army is divided into two fronts and migrated south. Tunon sent word that you were to join the next frontier of Kyros' conquest, either as judge and overseer of the settlement of Leviathan's Crossing, or as a war advisor with the armies advancing into the realm of Apex. So we gotta choose Apex. It would make more sense for us to be a war advisor because of our pit fighter experience. Fits our RP better. We're going to Apex. All right, here we go, guys. I'm excited. Oh, we've got more choices. We've got a lot more choices. The mountains. This is not the full game. This is just our setup. So, please be patient, chat. The mountain nation of Apex ruled for generations by the Queen House Vendrian stood at the heart of the Tears. No army could bypass the landlocked realm without leaving their flank exposed to attack. By the second year of the war, that is favored in Scarlet Chorus had pushed deep into the Tears. Emlets of both armies were dispatched to conquer Apex. Tunon assigned you to accompany them, tasked with bringing Kyros' law to the territory as well as keeping an eye on both armies. Alright, so we have more decisions. I'll try to go through this a little faster. Denial of Strength. A new school of mages presented problems and opportunities. No mages. We don't even have to look at anything else. We're going full hog Scarlet Chorus. For sure. Alright. Scarlet Chorus' soldiers were found wearing this armor and armor. The local custom of the Tears created strife between Kyros' armies. Scarlet Chorus soldiers were seen wearing disfavored gear, supposedly taken from those who fell in battle. The disfavored were outraged, citing tradition that their armor passed only the next of kin within the army. In a debate of tradition versus practicality, you had to rule in favor of one army over another. You denied the disfavored's complaint, as demands of war rendered such vain customs irrelevant. Lacking in suitable armor, the Scarlet Chorus would retain what they had collected. Yeah, sorry, disfavored. No thanks. The Scarlet Chorus nominated you to negotiate with the Realm of Apex representatives and convince them to surrender, trusting you to explain their inevitable defeat in terms they will understand. How do you orchestrate the surrender of the enemy? Taunting the Queen of Apex into striking you under a banner of truce, you baited the Queen of Apex into a duel and slew her, frightening her vassals into submission. What is the other option? Through days of mediation, no, we don't want to negotiate. We're active. Scarlet Chorus again. Alright, so it looks like we have two more of these. Alright, so let's read. We have another destination choice. Oops. Kyros' conquering gaze fell upon Vellum Citadel, its treasures, its knowledge, its secrets. Okay. With its easily defended position and rich military tradition, the realm of Starwell has the most formidable realm in the Tears. Okay. Here's dispatched the Archon of Stone to subjugate the nation of Azure. I like this formidable realm. We'll go with Stalwart. All right, two more choices. I mean, two more sections like what we had seen. All right, marching on empty. Tragedy struck when hungry Scarlet Chorus soldiers appropriated his favored supplies. A stinging defeat led to activations among Kyrus's armies. Let's help out our Scarlet Chorus fellows, shall we? The stalwart defenders burned their crops as they retreated, leaving the invaders little to forage. Starving, the Scarlet Chorus mob raided from the disfavored well-maintained supply lines. Sorry, disfavored. We don't like you at all. By your command, the disfavored shared their provisions. The thieves each lost a hand for their treachery. Scarlet Chorus commanders argued that the Horde was starving, being the largest of Kyrus's armies, they were also the least provisioned. The men were wrong to steal, but the disfavored were equally wrong to withhold supplies from their allies. You agreed with the Chorus version of the events and ordered that the disfavored supplies be shared. The thieves themselves would be punished with loss of a hand and returned to the front line. The disfavored found this a sickening aberration of justice and surrendered their supplies with grudging acceptance. Sorry, disfavored. Not today. All right. A string of mass suicides led the Scarlet Chorus making demands of the disfavored. Yep. We're just going to dig the disfavored into a hole. We're choosing Scarlet Chorus no matter what. That's how we're doing this conquest. All right. I know you guys are a little tired of the reading. I find it super interesting, but I know that's not for everybody. So we're gonna move on here. We're going to skip ahead. You reach the end of Kyrus' conquest. Do you want to continue or want to continue? The disfavored are terrible. Scarlet Chorus rules. That's how we're doing it. All right, we're actually getting into the game. That is a statue that looks like it's crying blood. Okay, here we go. Man, so rough on the disfavored. Yes, we are. Yes, we are. We're brutal. This is a game about being brutal.
The year is 431, and Kairos' invasion has shattered all major opposition in the Tiers. The Younger Realms, the Bastard Tier, the Free Cities. All who defied Kairos lay broken by battle.
Kairos, not Kairos.
The two armies of the Overlord, the Disfavored and the Scarlet Chorus, now control our lands. But our will is not yet extinguished. Not entirely. In the Valley of Vendrian's Well, those of us unwilling to bow to Kairos have banded together in defiance. Violating an oath of surrender from 2 years prior, we have staged a bloody uprising, murdering the Disfavored and Scarlet Chorus garrison in a midnight assault.
Night assaults, I like this.
With their main forces spread across the Tiers, the Disfavored and Scarlet Chorus redeploy to Vendrian's Well to crush the resistance. But months pass with no definitive battle. As disagreement and discord paralyze the Archons, we bide our time and wait for our message of insurrection to spread across the Tiers. The Overlord is not amused, and Kairos has one message for the Archons. Crush the Oathbreakers or die. Kairos backs this threat with an edict, a magical commandment that can slay all in the valley should the order be ignored.
Wow.
The honor of proclaiming this edict fell to you. Sent across the mountains to Vendrian's Well, you carry the Overlord's edict to read before the Archons.
If you don't do this, you all die. That's interesting. It'd be a fun thing to use in tabletop escapades.
As you finally make your way through the winding mountain passes into the valley, the ground trembles, and Kairos's magic seals the way behind you. You are trapped in Vendrian's Well, with Kairos's armies and the Oathbreakers. The only way to survive is to fulfill the terms of the Overlord's edict, in any way that you can.
This is your first visit to the world of Tyranny. Watch for these windows to help you become familiar with the game. You can disable tutorial messages at any time from the game options menu. We'll probably need them. All right, here we go. Yes, this looks like a classic RPG already. All right, let's do this. Let's get into this game. We should figure out what all this stuff means first, right? Select all party members. Okay, F5 or backspace. Stealth toggle, okay. Formations, yes. Yes, very familiar with that. Okay, and camping, all right. So these are our abilities, thrust, cleave, palm strike. Cooldown 31 seconds, 31 seconds, 25 seconds. All right, awesome. Oh, nice, and we can see the range of this stuff as well. All right, so that's pretty useful. Let's talk to you. Kairos, the Overlord, be praised! When I heard the avalanche, I feared the valley was sealed with you on the other side. The disfavored warrior clasped her gauntlet to her breastplate, the traditional salute of her legion. We don't like the disfavored. We're gonna have to get in a fight, I think. Alright, conversations. Conversations involve you, another character, and sometimes additional parties, like bystanders or companions who may interject. The choices you make change how the story develops, and will build a reputation for your character over time. People in the world will learn of your reputations, good and bad, and respond accordingly. Your character's attributes, skills, history, and gender, as well as decisions you made in the conquest, may all open up options for you in dialogue. These options are not necessarily superior to other responses, but give you a wider variety of choices to select from. The manner in which someone responds to your choices depends on their individual personality and attitude. Each character who speaks to you will display a banner beneath their portrait. These banners indicate which faction the character is allied with. The tooltip on these banners will provide details about how that faction feels about you. Favor, 0. Wrath, 0. Okay. You will often see the names of important characters and locations displayed in a gold text color. The tooltips on these glossary entries will provide you with important information on the world. Okay, cool. All right, so we don't fulfill this requirement. We don't have the skill. We don't care about lore. We're going to RP really hard here. Okay, what does she say? Aurora says, sorry, I don't have a proper welcome for the Queen Slayer. Uh-oh, perhaps if I weren't so short-handed, I could have made preparations, but no bother. We are honored to have you all the same, and I look forward to seeing the Oathbreakers lose their cool at the sight of you. All right, so we're a big deal. Glare silently. I'm in a hurry to deliver the message to the Archons. I come bearing an Edict of Kairos. Our soldiers will complete their task or die. I like that. We're sending a message. Do this thing. The edict is leveled against us. Her eyes widen with fear. Her posture slackens. But the Scarlet Chorus prevents us from taking action. Why would the Overlord punish both of... She clears her throat with a sigh. Forgive me, it is not my place to question. We should have conquered the enemy within weeks of arriving in the valley. The delay reflects poorly on all of us. If we follow Kairos' will and stop the insurrection, no harm will come to any of us. Glares silently. Two Archons and their armies cannot take a citadel they've taken before. Of course, Kairos is displeased. I kind of like glaring silently. Like, staring at her as she's just afraid. I think our character would do that. I also like the third option, too. Maybe we'll do that. Okay. We'll do that. We're saying we're displeased here. Your words sting, but they are not false. The soldiers stand ready, yet the Archons never issue the charge. If anything can force them to act, it will be the Overlord's edict. Well, you've traveled a long way, and I won't keep you further. I'm sure the Archons will want to hear from you at... Her voice fell silent, her attention snapping eastward with alarm. Did you hear that? More runners. Third time this week, the Oathbreakers keep trying to send messengers through the mountains to gather help from outside the valley. She points over to Clasp's path with you arrived. But they're a bit too late for that now. Come, let's show these Oathbreakers a good fight. Here we go. Our first combat encounter. Whoa. Mouse is going a little crazy. For the glory of Kairos. All right, here we go. Look at his armor. Tyranny uses a pausable real-time combat system. Because you will often manage more than one character at a time, it's a good idea to pause the game and issue orders and resume real-time to see those orders play out. The options menu also contains many choices for automatic pausing when certain conditions are met. Press spacebar to pause or unpause the game. Alright, so classic stuff. Your character is always perform basic actions using their equipped weapon or their fists if fighting unarmed. Characters also have special abilities and spells they can use in combat. All of your character abilities and spells can be accessed by selecting the category icon at the bottom of the selected frame. Okay, cool. Talent, spells, combo abilities, and artifact abilities, reputation abilities, and stances. Category icons for weapon sets and quick items will follow, okay? To use an ability, left-click on the ability or icon and press the hotkey corresponding to its location on the ability bar. Your cursor will change to indicate whether your mouse is over a valid target. Okay. All characters in the game, friend or foe, have five primary defenses against attacks. Parry, dodge, endurance, will, and magic. These defenses are based on the character's attributes. Gotcha. Accuracy is compared to the appropriate defenses when an attack is made. Okay, there are four possible results from any attack. Hit, critical hit, graze, and miss. Critical hit increases your damage, while a graze reduces it. With each attack, you gain experience in the weapon's skills used to make the attack. Even a miss will grant some experience. Okay, so let's buff up our greatsword here. We have a thrust ability. Yes, that we want to use. Single attack. We're going to use it on this. There's a 69% chance that this will work.
I got it.
All right, let's unpause. Let's do this. We also have cleave, which we don't. We're only fighting one target. I kind of want to do searing palm because it just sounds really cool. And there's a 77% chance this is going to work. So we're going to do searing palm. Wait, did that not? Is it because I have the greatsword? It's probably because I have the greatsword equipped. That's why that's not working, right? Yeah, okay. That makes sense.
Right.
We'll just chop him down. No big deal. We're not taking much damage, so that's good. We'll finish him off with another thrust. Or not, just a regular swing. Alright, that's one down. Let's check further along the path for more. All these people being hung up. Never forget to loot, by the way. Alright, what do we get? Whetstone. Two armor, penetrated by attacks for 300. Okay. Potion of Protection, plus 2 armor. Okay, that's really good. Can we... Alright, so this is our inventory. Quick items. Do we not loot that thing? How do I use that? Oh well. We're in the beginning of the game, this should be fine. But where did it go? What am I missing, chat? We will bathe in their blood for the glory of Kairos. I like it. I like the attitude, chat. Alright, something's going on. Let's talk to Aurora again. We should be vigilant and deal with the remaining Oathbreakers in the pass. This seems like a suicide mission. What do the Vendrian Guard hope to accomplish? We would never say that. I've been traveling for days. How much longer I teach the Archons? No, carry on. Let's fight. That is what our character would do. Can we roll this boulder on them? A rock slide blocks the path ahead. You can squeeze through a narrow gap between the stones, or you can attempt to push one of the boulders out of your way. We're pushing. We wouldn't squeeze. And we have athletics. Oh, cool. So our athletic skill is helping us do that. Press your weight against the boulder and directly in your path until it starts to move. Yes, we're pushing the boulder. Yes. All right. So we got a free kill out of that. That's fantastic. Brute strength will also work. I'll head back to my post to ensure no one else makes it out of the valley. You should fight with us, Aurora. A cleave would be good here. So we'll use that. We'll get both of them. Wait. Does that not do what I think it does? A sweeping cone that hits multiple nearby enemies. Okay. I think I only hit one enemy, though. So I didn't do that right. Let's keep attacking. So this circle will indicate when I do another auto attack. So when that goes down, I should be able to swing against this guy. All right, we're figuring this out slowly. I'm glad he's distracted by this other soldier. That's good for us. All right, so we should just be able to swing this guy to death. Hi everyone, I'm back. Hi, Silent Constant.
For the glory of Kairos.
For the glory of Kairos, indeed. You die this day. All right, cool. Can I loot anything?
Cautiously.
Oh, all right. Sun Shoulder's Javelin does a little bit less DPS, has better recovery, accuracy, and armor protection as a melee attack. Okay. I don't think we're going to use that because we love our greatsword. We don't want to stealth. We're not a stealthy character. All right. Let's keep moving forward. Let's see what you've got. A mushroom. Happily, I'll take this. Revive when defeated for 120 seconds. All right. Brings us back to life, it seems. That's really good. All right, let's look at stuff. Several skulls, bleached by the sun and picked clean by carrion birds, are spiked on a roughly hewn post. It is only heraldry the Scarlet Chorus needs. All right, more fights, more battles. Oh, I bet those are Scarlet Chorus people. A young Scarlet Fury weaves around the Vendrian guard attackers, avoiding their weapons with fluid grace. She nods to acknowledge you. She looks awesome. Sun Soldier, a breathless enemy soldier, passes a glance to her countrymen. This one's crazy. Too much lead in her water. We should cut our losses and turn back. You're going down.
Finder. You're here at last. Care to join me in putting these cowards out of their misery?
She nods to the armed soldiers bearing down on her. Absolutely. We're going to kill these cowards. That is absolutely the correct choice. For the realm of Apex, charge. The Vendrian Guard level their weapons and advance. Yes, I don't care if there are three of them. We're taking them out right now. All right, so we're gonna move closer, first of all. Oh, so I'm controlling both of them. Okay, companions. The companion versus joined your party versus a capable warrior skill in both melee and ranged combat. You need to balance strengths, all right. There are now two characters in your party and both selected. Any command you issue will now affect both. Okay, we want to control them one at a time. Okay. Verse has several stance abilities that provide her with different benefits in combat. Alright. So let's check these out. We're paused right now, so we should be good. What are her abilities? Skewer. Verse thrusts both of her weapons into the target, penetrating armor. That seems really good. She's dual-wielding. Good. Launch a burning arrow that sets foes on fire. Coordinate with Verse to knock your target prone and then follow up with a strong bleeding attack. Yeah, we want that. So we're going to knock you down.
We can do this!
Okay, we didn't knock her prone, which is bad. So I'm going to have her do Skewer. Oh, maybe I need to select both of them for that to work. I'm going to try to cleave. I'm actually not close enough to cleave, so I'm gonna get
ready for another.
Okay, so one's dead. Can I cleave both of them? Oh, I'm rooted. Oh no, what did I get rooted by? Versus several stance abilities that provide her with different benefits. Yeah, we saw that. Okay, well, I'll just do a regular thrust then. And then can you... I actually don't want you to move. I want you to attack. And then you're almost dead, so we'll just use a regular attack against you.
You little shit.
Yeah, we got this. We're fine. We have plenty of health. Oh my gosh! I spoke too soon. That was a lot of thrusting that just happened. Okay. And I can't... Oh, I can use this. Okay. Does that mean I can use my unarmed attacks? Oh, I can. Yeah, okay. Okay, that was dumb.
Wait out, you little shit.
All right, this burning fist is awesome.
I can tell you didn't spend the conquest.
So I can use all of my abilities. A lot of thrusting that just happened. Jeez, Ben, lewd. Yep, unintentionally blue. I can tell you didn't spend the conquest in a diplomat set. Absolutely. Verse gets us, man. The fighter surveys the fresh corpses and nods with satisfaction.
I'm Verse, by the way. But there are more important things to take care of than introductions. Those Vendrian guard we killed didn't come alone.
She gestures to the skirmish unfolding the past below, shaking her head.
Join the battle. I'm ready if you are. That's probably going to be our option. Not so fast. First, explain what you're doing here. Why are the Vendrea Guard attacking now? You fight like a storm. What's your role in the army? No, we're just fighting.
Eager.
No need for words.
I like that. Before we go, you might search among the remains of our fallen comrades. Wherever they're bound, I doubt they'll miss their boots, much less any rings or any useful iron they might be clutching.
You should honor your fallen, not pillage them. Oh man, this is actually tricky for me because I feel like our character would honor the fallen. She's all about combat. She's spent her entire life fighting. I want the rings. Just as a player, I want them. But I think we're going to let the RP override this. And we're not going to pillage. We're going to say not pillage them.
If they deserved my praise, they'd be standing here taking orders. As it is, they're dead and I'm alive. The beating of my heart is celebration enough. Apparently you haven't spent enough time in the front lines or you'd know that.
Okay. She convinced me. They're not worthy of our praise.
For the voices of Narat!
She didn't like what we did, by the way. We made a bad decision there. Ceremonial Fatebinder of the Tunon Helm. That's a healing potion. Okay, we already have 5 of those, but more is welcome. We're not going to be using scrolls at all. Don't care about that. Okay, so I think we've looted everything we can. Let's select both of our people and move forward. Yeah, I don't need to read about spell scrolls. Not important to us. So, oh, I can move down here. Nice. Let's move into this camp. I don't know, man. She was a pitfire. Wouldn't that mean she's only worried about herself? I like that. I like playing it that way. We haven't completely defined Mirella yet, but Candy Coated Thorns, I think that's a good suggestion. We'll probably go with that. She only cares about herself. She's very selfish, looking out for herself. She was raised in the pits. So it was a very hard life. Okay. Tarkus Demos. Eyes forward, no looking back. The Vendrean Guard warrior roars with his falx head high, his words largely lost over the din of combat. Queenslayer! The warrior rears back his swinging arm as the invective hisses off his tongue. I've long dreamed of laying claim to your skull. So nice of you to present yourself. You arrived at camp and they already gave you a title? Impressive. As he signals his men to charge, the sound of chanting rises from the south, drawing his attention. Scarlet Chorus reinforcements, hurry! Oh boy, back up. Mocking Blaze is this guy's name. Run down the Oathbreakers, let none escape. From the red mob of reinforcements from the south, a blood chanter emerges at the head of the rabble, the ornamental crest of her staff pulsing with crimson tones. Signaling sigils of magic and wordlessly moving her mouth, the blood chanter scribes a series of spells into the air. A red glow surrounds the Vendrea Guard warriors as the chanter's magic worms its way into their minds, blinding them with rage. We don't like magic, but Mocking Blaze is pretty cool. Hold position, all of you. You there, keep to the path, the warrior gestures along the canyon trail, but his soldier turns their attention to the Scarlet Chorus, roaring challenges. No, don't engage them. We need to run. His orders falling on deaf ears, the warrior reluctantly readies his weapon.
Heads up.
Time to fight. When you have companions in your party, you are able to execute unique, powerful abilities called companion combos. These abilities allow two characters to act in concert to create a powerful effect. Try using the blood-soaked stone combo ability against Tarkus Demos. We'll do that. When a companion combo ability is activated, you will see the icon above each character's head is set to the same ability. The combo will begin when each character is out of recovery when the blue circle around the ability icon is gone. Okay, simple explanation. Fair enough. So if I select both of them, we're in attacker stance. Can I do this? Press 3? Like, do I have to have both of them selected? Or do I do this and then press 3 and go forward? Okay, so yeah, now it's above both of their heads. We'll attack. Yes, okay, so that worked. And then I stab them! Oh my gosh, that's so cool. So, Verse knocks them over, and then Mirella stabs them in the chest. What a cool ability. Alright, am I within range to cleave both of these guys? I should be able to. Yeah, so I can get both of them. Oh, I can hit all three of them. Nice. Alright, let's do that. And then you're using an ability that I want you to use. Yes! The Mighty Cleave. Okay, and we hit all of them, it looks like. This person's almost dead, so let's use a thrust. No, we don't want to waste a thrust, actually. We just want to do a regular auto attack. Another scar? Fine. Okay, you're dead. You're lower on health. So we'll deal with you. Yeah, Mirella, attack here. Verse, attack here. That makes sense. We disengage successfully. Our ability's up. Yep, thrust is up. We're gonna use thrust. 69% chance to work. Alright, cool. Basic auto attack should finish this guy off pretty easily. Verse is not doing well on health. I'm gonna go ahead and use that for her. Restore a little bit. Much better shape. And then let's just use all of our abilities. Why not? Take my burning fist. Only a 42% chance to work here, it seems like, but. Oh, she's on fire! That's brutal. I love it. Awesome. Okay, cool. That was fun. Come quick. We have a situation on the cliffside. They have the commander. Not the commander. Let me be the commander. I've got a burning fist. Alright. Good stuff. Ooh, Horde Bracers. This is good for us. Plus one defection, deflection, better recovery, better precision, better unarmed DPS. We want all of that. Potion of Elemental Barrier, plus 50 defense against paralyzed, burning, and frozen attacks. That seems useful. Bent Bronze Sword, not a two-handed weapon, not a two-handed weapon. Sorry. Party stash. Oh, okay, so this is our party stash. This is where all of our items went. Got it. Got it. Makes sense. I see. Okay. So we can equip these. And is there anything else we want? We want these to be on our quick menu, in case we need them. Boost our defense a little bit. Good, good, good. Okay, all right. I think we're good. Actually, we should give Verse some more potions as well, I think. That would be smart, huh? Yeah, in case you need them. What else do you have on you? Rot Spear. Enraged Affliction for 120 seconds, plus 4 Might for 120 seconds. When crushed between the teeth, Root Spear Seeds increase a soldier's might at the cost of inspiring Frenzy's Rage. That's awesome. So Verse just eats this and then goes into a rage. Very cool. Scarlet Poison. When inflicted upon the enemy, Scarlet Poison causes lasting damage. Okay, so a dot. Verse is such a cool character. Very into it. Alright, is there anything else we can loot? Yes, there's this box over here. What is the... Okay, so tab lets us see everything that we can click on. That's very helpful. Plus one resolve for 600 seconds. Okay. Good stuff. Alright, so we can move forward. How's chat doing? I've been ignoring you, chat. I'm sorry. Internet went down. What did I miss? Ben punched an enemy into a smoldering crisp. I sure did. I sure did. G Gundam references. I'm glad this this chat understands. All right. More loot. We got to get all of the loot. Very important. Verse looks so cool. I am glad you agree, Candy Coated Thorns. Ooh, a dead soldier we can loot. I thought that was raw meat for a second. I was getting scared. All right, so this is slightly better armor, but some bad other stuff. I don't think we want to equip this. I just don't think we do. Ooh. Crying blood. Or it looks like blood. Stow your weapons, or we find out how long a man screams before hitting the ravine down below. Cornered between a precipitous drop and a band of angry soldiers, the Oathbreaker warrior holds at his favorite officer at knife's point. Guys, we don't care about the Dishonored, remember? We'll see how this goes. Skewer him! Worry not for me! Graven Ash will protect. That his favorite officer winces, blood seeping from the stream of his bracers and cuirass. You heard the man. He plainly invited you to use that little blade of yours. What are you waiting for? Permission from your pimp? Whoa, Mocking Blaze. This blade, with a jerk of the knife, he slices off a clump of Drastus's matted hair. If you're so eager to see your ally dead, just step closer. Release the prisoner and you might know the inside of a cell. Conquest. Why kill that disfavored nobody when you could take your swing at the Queenslayer? Lower your weapon, then charge forward and wrest the knife from him. We have to help Drastus. You heard Drastus, let him die. I like using our conquest option. Why kill this nobody when you could fight me? You, the Queenslayer, pushing Drastus to this side, Pelex Tyrell bounds forward with murder in his eyes. His glorious charge ends somewhat abruptly as the disfavored soldier steps in, weapons out, and butcher Tyrell. Dazed but alive, Drastus lets out a long sigh and struggles to his feet. Not today. Kairos be praised. The Oathbreaker fought with the rage of Cairn himself. Drastus slides a trembling hand along the cut of his neck. Thank you, Fatebinder. I thought today was my last. We did save a disfavored. I don't know how I feel about that. From the look of it, guess they thought if they swarmed the pass, maybe one might make it out. We found a few scraps of parchment on the bodies. Drastus holds out a handful of crumpled parchment for your inspection. A student of letters such as yourself should be able to make sense of this. I have no time for this. I should be on my way to see the Archons. All that training in Graven Ash doesn't teach you to read? We're going to insult here. The commander stares at you, unamused. I have no time for this. Well, from the look of it, we kept them from slipping out of the valley. Whatever they hope to accomplish, I think their plan died here. The Archons were expecting you. When you're ready, leave by the gate to the southeast and follow the trails downslope for a few hours. You'll see the campfires leagues away. Can't miss it. Sure thing. We can lose this body, though. We don't care about scrolls. We're not going to take that at all. Plus one finesse. What is this, cheese? We love cheese. Quick finger bangles. Quality fine. Right click. Oh. Okay, so we can equip these. They're an accessory. Two-handed. Two-handed Falks. Bronze greatsword. More DPS, more accuracy. We absolutely want that. Thank you kindly. Okay, so that icon was indicating that it's going into our stash. Yes. New weapon. This thing looks cool. This curved giant blade. I'm into it. And then we have accessories as well, right? Yeah. Get some quickness going. All right, what time is it? 4:09. Chat, I have to use the restroom real quick. I will be right back. Why not keep the scroll to sell? That is a good idea, and I think our character would do that. I think our character, despite hating magic, would be willing to sell it. Looking out for herself. That's a good idea. I didn't think of that. Le jerk. I like it. All right, be right back, guys. This will only take, like, a minute. Hey, everyone. Sorry about that. Appreciate your patience. And I love these Godfrey emotes in chat. Let's get a Godfrey wall going. Why not? Good vibes. I hope you're all enjoying Tyranny. I'm really enjoying it. You know, we don't stream games a lot like this. So this is kind of a nice change of pace for me personally. All right, so he said to go southeast, right? Let's do that.
Sorry, I can't.
What does this icon mean? I don't know. They're running towards somewhere. Where are we running to? Where are we running to? Okay, so this is probably... I see. Okay, so we're going through the exit. What does this icon mean? We're gonna check this out. I just don't know what it means.
Can't do that.
Stance, 3 whispers, plus 20 dodge. Man, Verse is just too awesome. All these stances, dual wielding. Oh, climb up. Okay. So if we wanted to get in that way. Maybe there's loot up here, though. Our athletics really paying off, by the way. Yeah, there's a chest up here. Okay, that's pretty cool. Oh, but it's locked. Can I bash it open?
Can't do that. Sorry, I can't.
Is that possible to do?
Can't do that. Sorry, I can't.
Because in some of these games, you can just attack them. You have a chance of ruining what's inside, but... Okay, so we don't have any subterfuge. Just, does she have subterfuge? No. Okay. So that's not going to work out. All right, climb down. If I miss something there or I can get in that chest, let me know, chat.
Sorry.
But it doesn't seem like I can. But I love that. I love when the way you built your character matters so much. Pillars of Eternity was exactly like that as well, which is cool. It's probably just a spell scroll anyway. I like the attitude. No time for magic. All right. Let's move on. Where are we going? This favored camp. This fort was constructed shortly after routing rebels along the valley's western edge. The Archon, Graven Ash, directs all disfavored efforts from this location. Cool. Okay, since you asked, the chest actually just has a spell scroll in it. Requires 80 lore to learn. Okay. All right. Thank you. Glad we didn't miss out on any sweet two-handed weapons or something like that. Guess I'll be heading back to work. Bye, everyone, and thanks for streaming, Ben. You're welcome, Atoshi. Always nice to have you. Thank you for joining. Good vibes. Take what you can carry, but leave the cart. Otherwise, we seize you and your wares. Uh-oh. Robbing some poor man. Sterling Hagnon. Let's see what's going on here. Hail, Fatebinder, that his favorite scout gnaws at your approach. Camp's up ahead. Don't mind us, just clearing out the rabble. I still don't understand what I've done to offend. I respect that these are now disfavored lands, and I'm happy to give the Legion a proper toll. But she's going on about trading rights. What nonsense is that? I am not allowed to trade one thing for another. It's not like I'm selling weapons to angry peasants or anything of the sort. You're on disfavored land. These warriors have every right to kill you. You should be more thankful they're even listening to you speak. The Overlord regulates all trade. If you lack the proper permits, your goods are forfeit. This is none of my concern. Carry on. Okay. So I'm going to run this RP by you guys. Let me know what you think. So I think, you know, we're playing Tyranny. We have to be evil, but I don't think we have to be absolutely evil. And I think Mirella has a soft spot for just common folk, peasants, traders, because she was involved in a life of pit fighting, right? And we don't like, the disfavored are giving this man a hard time. We don't like that it's favored. Okay. We're Scarlet Chorus. So I think here we would just say this is none of my concern, carry on. Because that's like, it seems like the nicest option we could give. Maybe if we picked this, though, he will show the proper permits. I don't know. What do you guys think? Don't go soft, Ben. She was a slave sold by a merchant. That's true. We're going to pick option two. We'll see where this goes. I'm curious about it. I have to go to work at FedEx and keep Damiani's NES Classic away from him. That's pretty funny. A trade permit? Well, how was I mean, to whom would I speak for such a thing? Not us and not our problem. Maybe march your butt to Bastard City and plead your case before Tunon. But we'll lighten your burden and relieve you of your worries first. That should make the long trek a bit more bearable. I think only evil choices should be enacted if the choice benefits her. Otherwise, she probably wouldn't care. Giga Steve, I think that's a compelling argument. You're on disfavored land. These warriors have every right to kill you. Anything to be argued before Tunon may be argued before me. I like that. You had best start making a very strong argument as to why I should help you. I like that too. We'll pick that. You lost favor with his favor. Yes. Good. We want that. What's there to discuss? We should kill this mongrel and... The warrior pauses, placing her hand in front of her mouth. If the Fatebinder wishes to weigh in on this matter, courtesy demands that we listen. The soldier clears her throat, looking at you expectantly. This is a disfavored matter, but I know the agents of the court do so love to throw their judgments around. Well, you could rob me now and have my supplies today, the merchant grabs a flask from his cart, or you can leave me alive and have fermented honey all year long. I even know a few family recipes for painkillers and healing draughts. Certainly any army will need those. He uncorks a small ceramic vial and the aroma of cloves and lanolin assaults your nose. These are essential goods to the war effort. We should leave the supplier intact. We have to pick that because we don't have any of these other options available to us, and we're not respecting that his favorite at all. So we're picking option one. But he has no permits. You're allowing this lowborn wretch to profit when he should toil like any other conquered tearsman. Fatebinder, it is your right to settle disputes when we lock horns with the chorus, but you have no authority on this matter. But I have the authority to write him a trade permit. Trust me, he'll be of use to the Legion. The disfavored will tolerate your presence, but you will pay them handsomely for such charity. Leave this cart as a gift for Graven Ash, then leave and never come back. Athletics! Intimidation! Step closer. Are you questioning my judgment? We obviously have to pick that. You lost favor with the disfavored. You gained wrath with the disfavored. You gained 52 athletics expertise. Experience, excuse me. I am... You have the right to step in when we disagree with the chorus, but this fool is sworn to the Archon and has no protection. The scout runs her hair along her temple, letting out a long hiss of frustration before throwing her arms in the air. You know what? Have it your way, Fatebinder. This isn't worth a court summons from Tunon. My deepest thanks. I thought I was about to be robbed and left for dead. And here I thought this favorite would thank me for bringing them fresh provisions. I'll be sure to keep my head down and not make any waves. I'm very happy with this outcome. Sorry, disfavored. No one likes you. Have to remember, there's an edict in this place. This region is totally cut off, so people like him are needed now. Absolutely. Absolutely. Good, good, good. I like that Chad is invested in our roleplaying. I can't steal from him, sadly. Can he sell things to me? Slow down a moment. I know we're both eager to watch the Archons bicker over tactics like a pair of magpies, but I need you to ask you something first. Okay. We'll listen to Verse. We respect Verse. The voices of Nerat told me that you've come as a mediator concerning the source. Well, I can't help but feel like I'm only hearing half the story, so let's have it out. What's so special about you? I'm here to deliver an edict from Kairos. Yes, that's true. I have nothing to tell you. Why is it suspicious? What else have the voices of Nerat told you? We're here to deliver the edict. You gain loyalty with Verse. Nice. That makes a crazy kind of sense. Considering how long the siege has taxed the armies, I can understand why Kairos would send you with an edict to speed things along. Have you read it? Do you know what it says? The Archons must claim Ascension Hall by Kairos' Day of Swords, or all will perish. One more thing for the Archons to fight over. Well, thanks for cluing me in. If Kairos sends any lightning our way, just tell me when to duck. Hey, don't let me hold you back. I'm sure whatever you're here to do is important enough that you don't need me stepping in your path. The war tent is just past the center of the camp. One last thing, be careful around these disfavored types. They take their work seriously, and most have suffered too many blows to the head. She is also mocking the disfavored, kind of. I'm into that. Alright, let's talk to this guy. Thank you for talking down the disfavored from doing worse. Sad times we live in when making a humble living is branded as a crime. So saving your hide was worth? Oh, well, naturally. He clears his throat, his face showing a flash of scowl. One good deed deserves another. While I have my shop up and running, I'll sell you provisions for a song and give you a proper bounty on any odd bits of weaponry you find. Provided that, he jabs a finger at you, you keep standing up for me should those iron goons try to rough me up a second time. Sure. You were lucky with us before, merchant. Take care you don't challenge your luck again. Let's see what he's selling. I'd like to see your wares. Okay, so we don't have a lot of the currency that this person is looking for. Is there anything we want to sell? We want to sell this. We want to sell this. Yep. Ooh, so this would give us bonus lore a little bit, and wits. I'm going to keep that. I'm going to keep the cheese. We love cheese. I don't want to use javelins. Even though this thing is probably worth it. I'm going to sell it. Oh, we should equip this helm. It's better than what we have, but we don't need three of them. We're selling the scroll, of course. Selling the sword, selling the dagger, selling this because it's worse than what we have equipped. Yep. Okay. All right, so we're getting a lot here. Nice. So we can buy a better helm, plus two armor. I don't think we need it. We don't need this bronze greatsword. What does this do? Delay unconsciousness for 10 seconds, plus 20 athletics for 120 seconds, plus 50 healing. I think we have enough for right now. I'm not going to spend any money. Ooh, camping supplies. We probably want camping supplies. Need to build a proper shelter from the elements. We want that. We'll buy as many as we can. Yeah. We want camping supplies. For sure. Okay, we've reached the maximum number of camping supplies. It's fine. Wait, I didn't see. I'm confused. Did I mess something up? Do we have camping supplies now? What? Oh, okay. Well, that's at 8. Yeah, so we have camping supplies. Good. Good to go. Oh, by pieces you don't have her suit up Verse. I was only thinking about myself here, but suiting up Verse is a smart decision. Absolutely, it's a smart decision. All right, so let's put this helm on. I already have a helm. How much better is this helm than mine? We'll put this on Verse. Yeah, look at that. Verse looks awesome. Okay. Yeah, suiting up Verse is a good idea. I didn't even think about it. Plus Plus 2 armor seems like a big deal. I don't like this minus 9% deflection, minus 3 accuracy. Maybe the plus 2 armor is worth it. I don't know. What about this? I think we're okay for right now. Hey everyone, how's the game been? I'm really enjoying it. We're playing it super slowly, but I'm enjoying it quite a bit. All right, going to the camp. Well, look at you, our gatecrasher from the court. It's still in one piece. The guard pounds his chest plate in salute. Welcome to Disfavor Camp. Always happy to have an honored ally pay us a visit. Okay. Glare silently. Go on in, the soldier gestures toward the gate. The Archons are expecting you. You'll find them in the war tent, center of the camp. Easy enough. The Conqueror's Will. Cool. Always love a good war camp. This is like where the trial of Yogala, or the trial of, yeah, the trial of Yogala took place. That's what it reminds me of. Who is this guy? Bitter Quip. These names are so good. Glory to the voices of Narat. Projecting his solution for all to hear, the grinning blood chanter wraps his staff against the ground as you approach. Fatebinder Morella, I presume. His smile quickly retreats, giving way to a sour scowl. I am Bitter Quip. I am here as the emissary of the Scarlet Chorus. Bitter Quip looks at you impatiently. He doesn't seem like who we need to talk to, so let's keep moving. Yeah, it seems like we need to go here, perhaps? Archons await you inside. Okay, so we gotta go in this... let's rest, I guess. Because why not? But this is the tent we need to go in.
I'd say that's worth it.
Keep her in light, keep Verse in light armor. Okay, yeah, that makes sense to me. Dual wielding berserker type. Look at this guy. And this guy. We got blue glow and green glow here. Hello, Ben. Hello, Oz.
Four reports of avalanches in the mountains now. The Tearsmen can barely count past 9. They have neither the capacity nor the cause to close off the mountain passes. Either way, that leaves the 2nd and 4th cohort trapped outside the valley.
The Archon of War pounds his staff on the ground to punctuate his words. A large and imposing man to begin with, his profile is made larger still by his hulking suit of armor that hums with mystic energy.
Or it's the work of your perfidious Earthshakers. Only a fool would not suspect a traitorous Archon of poisoning the mind of his students with sedition. We would have killed the Earthshakers Guild for their master's treachery, but I'm sure you have some perfectly valid reason for allowing them to live as your pawns.
I love the voices of Narat. That's a cool voice for this character. The Archon of Secrets passes his scepter between his hands as he speaks, twirling the rod in hypnotic circles. Emerald luminescence seeps from the seams of the Archon's ragged red robes. The glow is most noticeable where his neck ought to be. His mask seems to float and spin, never pivoting or bending naturally. Cool.
Hey, watch yourself. When these two get going, you don't want to get between them.
I'm here to proclaim Kairos' edict. The valley was sealed in preparation for this moment. Clear your throat. I'm going to clear my throat. I'm going to announce my presence.
I always know you've run out of things to say when you resort to mocking my vassals. If we are to speak of treachery, why is it that my scouts see the Scarlet Chorus warriors defecting back to the Vendrian Guard? Your fearsome reputation has gone flaccid, for it seems you cannot control your soldiers, or perhaps you simply choose not to.
Our fearsome reputation has gone flaccid. Ouch. My lords, the Fatebinder has arrived. The disfavored commander raises his voice. Her voice. The commander... man, I'm really off today on that, that his favorite commander raises her voice, trying, with little success, to speak over the Archons. Perhaps we could table this discussion and let our guests speak.
Speaking of strategic failures, who was it that insisted the Valley would need only a token garrison? For some strange reason, we can't seem to recall which balding half-wit grossly underestimated the enemy. Thoughts?
I love the trading of insults here. When the voices passes the scepter, mouse over the green words. Do they change? That's cool, because look at this. These green words are saying, you hear the voices in your head. Can you hear us, Fatebinder? Cough if we have your attention. Ooh! So we're communicating without letting Graven Ash know. I like that. Very cool. Yeah, we're definitely doing that.
And I thought you had left agents within these tearsmen when they surrendered. Either you failed to see this coming, or you knew and let it happen. Incompetent or in cahoots, either way, this mess has your filthy stink all over it.
The Archon of War lurches forward, resting his weight on his war maul as blue luminescence crackles around his armor.
We look forward to seeing you explain to Tunon why the Archon of War could not close the vice on this trivial little insurgency. When we are crowned the ruler of the Tears, we shall have this place renamed to Ash's Folly in your honor.
The voices of Narat tosses his scepter into the air, catching it as it descends back down. You hear the voices in your head. Good, good. Now pay attention. You might miss something. Okay. We like this guy a lot. We like the voices, so we're just gonna remain silent and see what happens.
If I could trust the information I get from you and your conscripted mouth breathers, perhaps I'd order my cohorts around a bit more aggressively. But last time I trusted your all-clear report, my troops failed to come home.
Oh, Ash, old boy. If you're going to have a little sob every time one of your nieces or nephews dies to the Tearsmen, perhaps we should have Siren sing you some calming lullabies to help you cope with your grief.
Siren is the Archon of Song, and the youngest Archon sent to conquer the Tears. Young and inexperienced, Siren is sworn the voices of Narat, who uses her powers of charm and manipulation to swell the ranks of the Scarlet Chorus with volunteers. The Archon flips his scepter three times around, humming gleefully. You hear the voices in your head. Take care that you don't learn too much, Fatebinder. An excess of knowledge, of curiosity even, can earn unwanted attention. Hold your tongue. I will not have you denigrate the honor of our fallen brethren. The commander's hand moves to the hilt of her blade. Though the weapon stays sheathed, I'd be doing us all a favor if I cracked open that excuse for a head. Fifth Eye. They bicker like children, do they not? The Fifth Eye's grating tenor pierces the tension in the tent, and all eyes land on the Crimson Spear. I only meant to say welcome. Welcome to our guest, the Fatebinder. The armored retainer bows with a rushed inelegance, then rises to salute, and at a moment too soon. You have gained favor with the voices of Narat. Good. Gained favor with the Scarlet Chorus. Good. Looks like we gained favor with Graven Ash and the Disfavored as well. Not good. The Queenslayer, sensing your presence, the Disfavored commander snaps into a firm salute. No doubt your presence here will strike despair into the hearts of our enemy. Lord Ash, Lord Narat, our guest is here. Bow to the Archons. Apologies for the sudden entrance. I've traveled long to be here. We're glaring silently.
Ah, the Storm Caller. Conveniently late once more. Our eyes and ears tell us you come bearing an edict. The anticipation is killing us.
Conquest decision. The Disfavored cut a bloody swath through the realm of Stalwart. By 4:30, it was clear the countryside had fallen, but the last of Stalwart's regents, the ruling family, would remain hidden in his massive keep at Sentinel Stand, unwilling to meet his final fate in a final battle.
My soldiers tell me you helped Commander Drottis on your way through Edring. You honor the court with your selfless cooperation. For that is the sort of camaraderie that Kairos demands of us all.
Hmm. Are you all done bickering? I have an edict to proclaim. I like that. I like being bold. Brazen.
My dear Binder, we won't be done bickering until the last of Ash's hair falls out. We'll pause for you to read your little missive. Go on, go on. Don't keep us all in suspense.
Voices like that, Grave and Ash did not. Exactly where we want to go.
Once again, you bring us support in a time of need. We fondly remember your service to the Chorus in the taking of the Bastard City. We knew back then you were destined for great things. But we had not anticipated you would be twice honored with the task of proclamation. So, do not keep us waiting. What is the Overlord's will?
The Overlord's loyal servants must hold Ascension Hall by Kairos' Day of Swords, or all in the Valley shall perish. That's option one. Option two, seems you need some encouragement to work together. Kairos' edict will end the lives of everyone in this valley unless Ascension Hall is claimed. In honor of your incompetence and disarray, the edicts will execute every living thing in this valley until Ascension Hall is taken by Kairos' Day of Swords. I don't want to insult voices, so we'll just go with option one. The earth sways with each word you utter, the air thickening with warmth as you pronounce the tersely phrased commandment. It's every syllable drafted by the hand of Kairos. With the edict proclaimed, your pulse quickens and the muscles in your legs, worn from a long trip down the mountains, feel renewed. The tired limbs now nearly buoyant with vigor. This is well written. Cool. The edict.
The Overlord means to compel us into action. No doubt the avalanches in the mountains are part of this ultimatum. We must conquer the Oathbreakers or die in failure. There is no room for error, and no other way out of this valley alive. We'll need to advance across the Mitanni. We lose everything if we stand still. And we move to back up Plan Green. The Earthshakers didn't make it over the mountain in time. So we do this the hard way. Over the walls, instead of through.
The Archon of War taps a finger against his temple. A low rumble escapes from under his beard. Hey, Jotan, it's good to see you. Playing some Tyranny here.
So, you found your backbone at last! Oh, we were worried past humiliations would make you soft, timid. That was a record for you, right? The Baker's Dozen lost in one sortie. If you had waited for the Chorus reinforcements, maybe we'd have eyes and ears on the matter.
The Organ of Secrets passes the scepters from one hand to the next, struggling softly with each toss. Your voice is in your head. Watch him squirm. So many tears over replaceable, expendable, useless soldiers. I miss the old Archon of War. You'd never see blood echo in a blubbering mess over a few dead killers. He'd use the knuckle bones of his best disciples for jewelry, and even made a breastplate out of his dead brothers. We'd respect blood echo a lot more than Graven Ash, that's for sure. I agree. Bicker all you wish, you're just wasting valuable time. That's option one. Option two, are you too daft? Is your indecision and bickering that necessitated this edict? Option three, learn to work together or we're all doomed. Remain silent. Option four, option five, subterfuge 20. They call you the Archon of Secrets, but you certainly don't seem to know anything remotely useful. That's pretty good. We'll remain silent,
though. You make it sound like you've been putting even the slightest effort into getting a foothold across the Mitanni, when all you've done is set your gangs to uncoordinated raids. You're the Archon of Secrets. Why is it you still don't know the enemy's full strength and capabilities? Maybe you know and choose not to share.
Look, if you're afraid to send more troops against the Oathbreakers, just admit that you're a coward and allow us to take charge of the situation. The Scarlet Chorus will be happy to prove it can do what the disfavored cannot.
Alright, I'm getting frustrated. Bigger than you wish, but you're just wasting valuable time.
The Fatebinder is right. We're acting not as leaders, but as children. I've no time for your foolish japes and petty taunts. We should focus on the objective at hand. And that is taking the Mitanni River, and then advancing to Ascension Hall and ending this edict.
No more sitting idle. I expected his favor to be on the march at once.
You've delivered your edict. Do not pretend it gives you the right to give orders to an Archon.
Oh, I just ordered you around. Take that. My lord, Beric and his band have been drilled on the Echo Call assault plan. The Crescent Runners should be briefing him as we speak regarding the latest enemy movements along the river. I will dispatch him at once. The Iron Marshal salutes, clapping her gauntlet to her breastplate. And I will ensure the chorus stands ready to march. If it is favored, can take the river, the chorus have the manpower to secure the outer ring of the valley.
Our soldiers clamor for battle, and at last we shall have it. Verse, we command you to continue guarding the Fatebinder. Tunon's chosen is our honored guest, and must be shown our finest hospitality.
Voices treating us right. I like that. I like that a lot.
I won't let you down, boss. She'll get through the campaign in one piece, as long as she doesn't do anything too stupid.
Verse, too cool.
And before we forget, we have a debt to settle. Last year, when our warriors got confused about supply lines, so kind of you to understand how things get muddled in the fog of war.
Okay. You hear the voices in your head. Suit yourself, Fatebinder. The more you ignore us. I don't want to ignore you at all. Catch the rings. You gain favor with the voices. Narat, you lost favor with Graven Ash. Good, good, good. And we got some money. The Archon of Secrets lets out a small chuckle as he leaves. Yes. Okay, good.
Fool and his puppet are gone. Perhaps now I can hear myself think. Rarely do I question Kairos's judgment, but I will never understand why the voices of Narat is given such authority. I shudder to think what will become of us all should Tunon favor him in the end.
Oh, we're favoring him, Graven Ash. It's happening.
The edict threatens the Scarlet Chorus just as it threatens us. Cannot shake the feeling that our allies will work against us. Queenslayer, I would ask that you join us in battle, if only for the satisfaction of your presence enraging the enemy. If you wish to be counted amongst the glorious, speak with the Iron Marshal. She will direct the order of battle until we are ready for the final push into the Citadel.
And what of the Scarlet Chorus? How will they be helping?
I ask myself that question often. While we take the river crossing, the Scarlet Chorus should be using their sizable presence to remove the Oathbreaker patrols lurking in the outer valley.
Glare silently. You gain loyalty with Verse, you gain wrath with Graven Ash, you gain wrath with the Disfavored. The Iron Marshal salutes Graven Ash and then turns to leave the tent. I will be at the training grounds readying the soldiers. Find me there when you are ready. Okay, is that our only option? She pauses, clearing her throat. And though I am loath to mention it, the chorus can likely use your assistance. Good. They certainly won't secure the Outer Valley on their own. Fifth Eye will be somewhere in that rat's nest they call a camp due east. Seek him out if you must. We're going Scarlet Chorus all the way. Ben has softened considerably. No, we've stuck with our Scarlet Chorus bias, I think. Now you've delivered the word of Kairos' edict to the armies. The time remaining! Oh, I didn't know about this at all. And Kairos' Day of Swords appears next to the current state on the navigation bar. The terms of Kairos' edict must be met by this date, or everyone in Vendrian's Well will die. We have 8 days! Cool. Alright. Let's go to the camp due east. Man, you were just deliberately angering half of your allies? Absolutely. Happy to do so. Play how you want to play, I guess, is the message of the day. This is a good-looking game. It's a cool camp. Okay, so we probably have to leave here, right, and go to the Scarlet Chorus camp. Yeah, this game has some of this. I think that's awesome. Put some tension on it. Make that edict felt, you know? That's really cool. I don't know if we're going to do well, but I like that it's there. This favorite camp, Scarlet. Yeah, we're going Scarlet Chorus. So this game has uneasy allies. It does. You'll love it even more when you're compelled to min-max for harder difficulties. For some reason, that really arouses my brain. That's a good phrase. Arouses my brain. I'm going to use that, Xyla Wolfbane. Deliberately angering half of my allies. The guard places her hands by her belt as you approach, gripping the hilt of the blade. Past this point is Chorus territory, and you don't look like someone's conscript. You sure you're in the right place? I'm Morella, Fatebinder of Tunon. I'm here to help vanquish the Oathbreakers. I'm always in the right place. Really? Let me guess, you're one of them Fatebinders. They like that. They like how straightforward I am. Did I tell you we had a special guest coming? This isn't just any Fatebinder. Morella here goes way back, been fighting with us since the Gates of Judgment. Show some fucking respect. Yes! The guard gestures you into the camp. Come on in, a veteran such as yourself is always welcome. Some respect. Fifth Eye, okay, so we want to talk to Fifth Eye. Ooh, what's this? Read scroll, we don't want to read scrolls. No, no, no. Alright, Fifth Eye. Take us away. Don't worry, Ben, you may anger your allies, but you make Cairo proud. Nice, 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 nice. The Binder of Tunon arrives, squealing with teenager's timbre. The Fifth Eye's voice makes your gums itch and your fingernails feel in need of a trim. That's great. And we just finished having a bit of sport with some captives, but worry not, we'll have more fun with another batch momentarily. Yes, we will. Dressed in the bronze red regalia of the Crimson Spears, the Fifth Eye beckons you to stand close, wagging a blood-spattered glove. Yeah, the dialogue in this is really fun. Now that you've issued this edict and doomed us all to die, have you come to help us climb out of this hole? Chirps of laughter emanate from under his mask. I trust you're getting the warriors ready for battle. Option one. Option two. Not here to follow your every order, but we all need to work together to stop this edict. Option three. How has the camp responded to the edict? Option four. I've got other things to do. Yes. Option one. Getting the warriors for battle. We know the Oathbreakers are focused in the citadel beneath the mountain spire, but we learn this is not their only nest. The Fifth Eye wags his hand in the air with a high-pitched squeal of displeasure. Given their pattern of attacks, they must have a second group maintaining a camp here in the Outer Valley. And unless we deal with the second group, they'll attack from behind the moment we cross the river. That his favorite think you can't control your horde, and that many are defecting back to the Vendrian Guard. Wrong, and perhaps he gestures with his spear in an arc toward the sprawling camp. It's a no mean feat to herd this many desperate lives. For every two hands of humanity, there's at least one finger that snaps from the stress of our ways. A few have been lost on the margins, I won't deny that, but if you store grain, expect some rat feces. If you lead killers, expect some desertion. If you store grain, expect some rat feces. If you lead killers, expect some desertion. Okay, alright. So you need help taking out the Oathbreakers. And while a good old-fashioned slaughter would be an efficient solution, the smart answer is to not kill them, but to add their strength to ours. Sure, that makes sense. My last group of scouts returned with a new batch of prisoners, and one of these prisoners claims she can lead us to the Vendrian Guard's secondary camp, though there are shreds of deception in her voice. I could use your help questioning this Varia Kell. Perhaps you'll get less screams and tears and more useful information out of her. If we knew where to ambush the Oathbreakers, we could try and take their captain and show him the wisdom of joining the chorus. I will speak to the prisoner. Ooh, we could do an interrogation. I like this. I'll meet you there. She's waiting by the other prisoners. Cool. Interrogate. Varia. They will not join, they will bleed. All glory to Kairos. Absolutely. This enthusiasm is good. Sorry. Chat is not working for me. Give me 1 second. Alright. Got about 15 minutes left. An interrogation is a good way to end on a crunch, I would say. Okay. Svitha offers a slight nod at our approach. Oh, okay, so he's not interrogating with us. Okay, so where is the prisoner? Boz Reg.
I'd say that's worth a second glance.
Why did we get subterfuge? What happened there? I don't know where the other prisoners are. So I guess let's just explore. We can loot as well. Shardglass vial. Okay, so this is just junk we can sell to a merchant. That's good. Let's look in this crate. Oh, you discovered a hidden object. The prisoner is tied up in front of you. Well, that's embarrassing. Oh, okay, yes. Okay, that makes sense. Of course these are prisoners. Alright, which one is the one we're looking for? Lantry. Fendrian card. Varia. Okay, this is the one we want. Varia Kel. Please, someone, I wish to bow before the voices of Narat. I thought all could find redemption. I actually thought these people were dead for some reason. But no, they're just tied up. They're just prisoners. I thought all could find redemption in the chorus. A woman in the makeshift armor of the Vendrian Guard lurches forward in agony. Her soiled, trembling legs suggest she has been forced to stand for days. Brutal! Brutal, brutal, brutal. Okay, this is definitely going to be a good crunch. I can tell already. Fifth Eye says, this one, he flippantly waves at the prisoner, was hollering earlier that she knows the location of the Vendrian Guard encampment. But she isn't being entirely honest. Varia Kel. I told this thing, the prisoner turns pale a moment, before a look of determination comes over her face, that I wanted a guarantee I'd live and be welcome into the chorus as a captain. Then I'll talk. Otherwise, they'll just kill me once I've opened up. I was dumb enough to join with the Vendrian Guard, but I'm not dumb enough to give away my bargaining bronze. Okay. Tell me what you know, and I can see to your release. You claim that you would disavow your people for the Scarlet Chorus. Why the change of heart? Why should I trust the words of an Oathbreaker? What is most like Morella? So we've decided that Morella is very self-interested, very into proving worth through strength. If Varia joins us, if she becomes part of the Scarlet Chorus, I think that's okay. Like, we want that. We want her to join our cause and bolster our ranks. We care about that. So option two, you claim you would disavow your people for the Scarlet Chorus. Why the change of heart? I think we're going to go with that. Because I want to live, and you don't need to be the Archon of Premonitions to know that the Younger Realms are gone for good. She blinks several times, catching her breath. Kairos is the new strength of the tears. I would rather stand with his archons than be crushed by them. Why should I trust the words of an Oathbreaker? I suppose I have no answer for that. Varia's eyes fall to the ground as she swallows nervously. When I joined with the Vendrian Guard, I accepted their broken vow unto myself. Have you not felt passion for a foolish cause, one you later came to regret? Well, my surrender is sincere, and I'm willing to bow before the voices of Narat to prove it. Okay. Tell me what you know, I can see your release. I heard the chorus is looking for Captain Pelix Florian and his crew. I can lead you to them, but only if you release me. She turns her head, taking a long look at skewered and smoldering corpses around her. She tugs at her restraints, but to no avail. Athletics, raise your voice. Start talking now. We could have the voices of Narat extract what you know from your mind. We wouldn't do that. We wouldn't do that. There's no mind extracting going on here. Start talking is what we want. Varia Kel says, well, you see, Shaken by your demand, her lips move wordlessly for several seconds. So I don't know exactly where the rest of the crew is, but I can tell you. She shakes her head, catching her breath. We did successfully intimidate her. Search that one. She reaches up her right leg and points with her foot, calling attention to a nearby pile of corpses. The tall, dark one, missing most of his face, check his left boot. He was the literate for one of our crew. He had the orders. With a snap of his fingers, a pair of choir men yank the boot off the fallen guardsman. A rolled parchment slides out of the boot and is thrust into Fifth Eye's hands. He unfurls the scroll to give it a read. It's nonsense, just a mash of words. Laughter erupts from under the mask. She said she had information. She gives us garbage. Slay this wretch for wasting our time. He snaps his fingers at a nearby Scarlet Fury, who promptly snatches a long knife from her belt. Remain silent, so I can let this happen. Or I say, I heard her say she'd swear fealty to the voice of Marat. An initiation rite would be in order. Again, I think we have to go with that one. I think we do want to bring her into the cause. We want to bolster her rank. Glory to the Scarlet Chorus. You gain wrath with Scarlet Chorus. Okay, so they don't like that at all. Fifth Eye says, seeing you are an expert on the subject of fate, I will entertain your wisdom on the matter. What, then, would you propose we do with her? Point to two other prisoners. Let's test her loyalty. Varia, kill these guardsmen with something blunt. Whoa. Negan. Option two, send her back as our agent. When the time comes, she will aid us, or we track down her kin. You're wasting a good slave. Work her until she's broken and feed her to the pigs. Again, we care about might. Let's test her loyalty. Let's do that. You're going to have to kill these guardsmen with a blunt object. That's brutal, but I think it's most appropriate for Morella here. You've gained favor with the Scarlet Chorus. Ooh! That smashing sound. Okay. Varia looks at the prisoners, once her allies, and closes her eyes as her bonds are untied. The onlookers snicker and cheer when a heavy rock is placed in her hand. Mouthing something inaudible, she lifts the rock high above her head and smashes it down on the prisoner's skull. Wincing back a scream as she hoists the stone over her head a second time to finish the job on the other prisoner. The bloody rock hits the ground and Varia slumps to her knees in defeat a moment later. That's awful. This is dark. Good, good. Fifth Eye places his bloody hand on the trembling woman's shoulder and nods to her. Welcome to the Scarlet Chorus. Do not fail us. As a pair of soldiers come to lift Varia, the Fifth Eye turns to you, his voice filled with glee. Where's a slave to clean up the offal when you need it? Dude. Dude, this is raw and I love it. Yeah, I hear you. I like it too. Fifth Eye says, we're no closer to finding the Oathbreaker's position. Not with this cryptic mess. She promised us answers and all she gave us was gibberish. That's true.
Sorry to interrupt, but I highly doubt it's gibberish. More likely, it's one of the local scripts.
Lantry? Why, hello there. Lantry, the voice comes from another prisoner tied up next to Varia, an older gentleman with the quills, ink vials, and parchment scrolls one finds on the sages of the School of Ink and Quill. Ink smudges cover his cheeks, temples, and ears. His clothes appear charred, and between the rips of fabric you spot burn scars along his arms. Despite being emaciated and tied to a post, he offers a beaming smile. Okay, I like Lantry. Show him the parchment. Can you read this?
Let me see. I can't...
You hold the parchment in front of the bound sage, and his eyes dart down the length of the missive. He reads the words a second time, nodding in silence.
So, I don't know exactly what it says, but I'm half certain that's Sage Selwyn's handwriting. I'm sure I could decipher that in a few hours' time. Don't need my hands free, but I think better when not tied to a post. I know, I'm weird that way.
Fifth Eye says, a few hours, either you can read it or you cannot. What use is a sage that doesn't know his letters? I've heard all I need to hear. I say we have some fun with this one. Option one, it can't hurt to give him a few hours. Option two, your life depends on you translating the scroll now. Another useless prisoner, dispose of him. Option three. I think we push him. Translate it now.
I would love to help. I just need some time. That's written in another sage's shorthand. I'd have to sit down with it, or better yet, compare it to a piece of his writing I have stashed on me somewhere. If I sat down with it while sufficiently sober, it's highly probable I'd figure it out.
Lantry is the best team member. Okay, that makes me want to keep him alive. But does that fit our RP?
Sober. Since when do we share the good stuff with the prisoners?
Verse, I love you.
Oh, nobody shared. Right before I was taken prisoner, I imbibed several vials of reagents. I wanted to be numb and disconnected when my captors used me for carnal catharsis. It's made these last few days tied to a post almost enjoyable.
Okay. So I just, as a player, want to keep Lantry, but I think, again, we can justify it with Morales RP because having this scribe translate this thing for us, if we give him some time, if he doesn't do it, of course we'll kill him, but if he does do it, that helps us and that helps our cause. So it can't hurt to give him a few hours. I think that works. Fifth Eye, if you read the edict, I don't need to tell you the sundial is working against us. That's also a very good point. This addled old bag is just trying to stall us. The voices of Narat will be upset to know you've squandered a source of enemy intelligence. I like that option. How true. Then we shan't put him to waste. He will serve as a most riveting source of amusement as we put him on trial.
Faithfinder, I beseech you, be my advocate for this trial. I'm no fool. I know the Chorus uses blood, not words, to settle these matters. But you are a servant of the Archon of Justice, are you not?
We need this prisoner alive. This is a terrible idea. When is trial by combat ever a terrible idea? The Fifth Eye chuckles a hearty laugh, waving his hand dismissively. If you are worried for his safety, fight on his side. The more blood shed, the more certain the verdict. You are our guest. The least you could do is honor our ways. Oh, man. We get a fight with him in a trial by combat? Yes. I will be his champion. This one needs to live. Let's do it.
Good. I like it when Tunon's puppies get their paws dirty.
Yes, yes, yes. Fifth Eye says, did you hear that, brothers and sisters? Raising his arms to the sky, the Fifth Eye roars for all nearby to hear. Trial by combat is upon us. Lantry, the sage is unbound from the post. Stiff legs nearly buckle as he attempts to walk, and his arms flex and flail in their new freedom. Wiping sweat and grime from his brow, the sage steps close to you with a nervous smile. Rhythmic roaring and the stomping of hundreds of feet in unison flood the camp. Hordesmen begin to circle and swirl about, brandishing weapons and cheering. Begin the chant of gathering. Let the warriors know that tonight's entertainment will soon commence. This is sick. We're not ending the stream yet. I've got to do this trial by combat before we move on. Let's go. Fifth Eye, brothers and sisters, who amongst you sets the standards for strength? Who amongst you will help winnow the weak from the strong? The Fifth Eye waves his hands in the air, drawing in a gathering of chorus soldiers. Our claimants have been assembled. Now let the trial of the Oathbreaker begin. All right, let's pause, of course. All right, what can Lantry do? I don't know what he can do. So he's a spellcaster, obviously. Quill strike. Look at this guy. Lantry throws a well-aimed quill at his target, interrupting them. That's hilarious. Renewal. Ooh, restores their weapons and armor to pristine condition. That's useful. Quicken. Lantry quickly heals the Fatebinder. Nice. Channeling healing energy into the target, restoring health. Okay, so he's a healer. He's a port character. Fill the target with a surge of greatness, granting them bonus to might and vitality. Yes, you're doing that. Make me great. please. And then I want to have you use this sweet ability, Bloodstone Stone. 85% chance. Let's do it! Make me great! Yes! You blew up into a lot of blood. Alright, so because he's a support character, he's actually already taken a bit of damage, which I don't like. I'm actually going to have you heal yourself. And I'm going to have Verse, you fight Gut Ripper, and then I'm going to have you fight this person. Yeah. In fact, let's use burning searing palm, because that's always good. Yeah. You're on fire. Okay, somebody's wounded. When a party member takes damage, they will start to lose health. The health bar next to their portrait will start to decrease. When a party member's health drops low enough, they'll gain a wound, and the health bar will turn to red. Wounded characters have a maximum health penalty. Have their maximum health reduced, receive a penalty to all skills. Wounds are removed when the party rests or character levels up. Ouch, brutal. I think we'll make it through this, though. I'll have him heal himself again as soon as he can, I guess. Just attack for now. We'll take care of this guy pretty quickly, I think. Gonna go ahead and do a stabby. Might as well set you on fire. Okay, yeah. Almost dead. Let's throw a quill at him. What do you say? Okay, they're dead. We did it! We saved Lantry. Trial by combat successful. By the righteous shedding of blood, we have found our answer. Regrettably, it appears the sage is worthy of leaving our camp alive. The Fifth Eye offers a short, mocking bow to Lantry. By the custom set forth by the voices of Narat, you are free to go, old man. Brag to your grandkids that you fell afoul of the chorus, yet live to tell the story. Pit Fighter! We get a Pit Fighter option! Look at this option! Pit Fighter, hold aloft a severed limb for all to see. That's absolutely what we want. You've gained favor with them. They love it. This is great. Everything's working out. Splendid, splendid. The Fifth Eye claps his bloody gloves as the crowd roars in approval. That's the spirit, Fate Binder. Show the dregs justice wrought from strength. He rubs his hand with a purr audible over the cheer. Only Narat had claimed you before Tunon did, alas. I thought I'd be tied to that post. The sage looks down at his rope-worn wrists in disbelief. Now hand me that parchment. I'm certain I can decipher it. Cool. Cool, cool, cool. Well, much of the parchment was weathered, but I couldn't make out the important parts of the text. The note makes mention of a meeting spot west of Trip Nettle. Now unlocked on the map. Fifth Eye, so the old sage knows his words after all. I'd ask you travel ahead and see if you can't get this Captain Florian to yield to the chorus. They'll strike at first sight of a chorus gang, but perhaps they'll parley if yours is the face they see. I know the area, I suggest we go at once. I'll show you the way. I'm eager to be far from the stench of this camp. Slow down. Introductions might be in order. My apologies. Guess we skip past that part. I'm Sage Lantry, formerly of the Vellum Citadel, and now of, well, nowhere, I guess. You're offering to come with me? Why? Because the alternative is what? Living here with these illiterate brutes? My old study is under a river of fire, and there's no family missing me. Besides, I'd much rather chronicle the binder that twice proclaimed an edict of Kairos. I'd be a fool to let someone else write your story. Swear fealty to me, and I will let you leave this place with me. Yes. You've gained fear with Lantry. Be afraid, Lantry. If that is your price, I will pay it. I, Sage Lantry of the School of Ink and Quill, do pledge my services and skine to the Fate Binder. And by extension, to the court of Tunon. He dips into a steep bow before rising with a solemn smile. I know I may seem old and frail, but I know how to step lightly and how to not get killed. Really, I won't slow you down. Lead the way and let me know if I can be of service. Are we done here? Let's hightail it to Trip Nettle. If your new pet doesn't behave himself along the way, I'm not above clipping his ears. Verse, you're still my favorite. That was great. Awesome. Well, that's going to do it. We ended it with Trial by Combat, which is a great way to end a stream. I had a ton of fun with this game. I know it was a lot of reading, a lot of talking, but I think it was interesting. I think the options they gave us were fun to kind of sort out with each other. Yeah, this was fun. I'm definitely going to play a lot more of this tonight, even. So I hope you all enjoyed. And thank you, everybody, for joining. All 250 of you. That's awesome. And yeah, we'll be streaming more Monster Hunter next week. I'll actually be streaming Yakuza tomorrow after Bloodstream. Not doing 3 to 5 tomorrow, doing 4 to 6. So if you want to watch more Yakuza, please come join me. And yeah, after this, Brad and Huber will be streaming Here's the Storm. Unfortunately, I will not be able to join them like I thought I would. But yeah, they're going to be doing that. It's going to be awesome. Thanks, everybody. Boopity boop boop. Bye.